Hi, my name's Amy Robbins and I'm team leader of Primates at Auckland Zoo. I do a lot of work with the orangutans here, and part of how we look after them is to do a lot of training with them, or operant conditioning. And so what that involves is asking them to present different body parts, and it can mean things like looking into their mouth, it can mean giving them an injection in their shoulder if they need to have an anaesthetic. I'm just about to go into a training session with Charlie. We do two training sessions a day, and we're just building up to almost being able to take blood from him. And so it's just taken a few months of slowly getting him used to putting his arm in and trusting us that we're not going to hurt him, nothing bad's going to happen, and he's going to get this constant reinforcement, or these constant goodies. And we only use really high value stuff to him, so things like honey and sultanas and all the goodies that he wouldn't normally get in his diet. Good boy, Charlie. So we had to get him used to the holding, and now we've started to introduce different kind of equipment that'll be associated with taking blood. So like the alcohol wipe, and then using the butterfly needle, and I've cut the end off the needle so it's still sharp but it's blunt and it's not going to pierce the skin. Done. We're finished. You're done. You're good to go. Being able to take blood is going to be a huge step for us in terms of how we look after the health of our orangutans. If we want to take blood from an orangutan now, we have to knock them out, so they have to have an anaesthetic just to take blood. So if we can take blood from them fully awake and fully voluntary, hopefully we can do that whenever they need to. So for example, if they were going overseas, that might save a knockout, or if one of them was sick. So we want to be able to know what a healthy orangutan looks like, and then what a sick orangutan might look like, in order to be able to provide the best treatment that we can.